The guy wants to be either out on the road making pictures or in his darkroom making prints. He has never been the slightest bit interested in publicity or anything like that. All he's interested in is working. But he isn't actively constructing his pictures with some intellectual mechanism. He's looking and working. And the mind sits behind it in a very interesting, very complicated way. He's not interested in some idea. I think a lot of art today is produced by people who have an idea and try to find some physical manifestation of the idea in the art that they make. And that's the opposite of what Lee is interested in doing. He's not the product of some educational system like the school programs today where somebody consumes the history of a medium and tries to decide where their work is going to be in relation to it. Instead, he's somebody who's worked and worked and found out what it is. When he wakes up in the morning, all he does is work in the darkroom. If I call Lee at 9 in the morning, he's already exposed and developed a whole box of photographic paper. So his life and his photography are completely connected. Jazz has been tremendously important to him. I think it's necessary to realize that Lee made a living early on photographing musicians, and he photographed musicians for album covers using a 2.25 camera and was very successful at it. The square color picture is something very unlike anything else he's done. I think when he looks through a piece of glass, or really through anything, but when it's a piece of glass with reflections, I think he's understanding that there's a picture there that won't ever exist unless he makes a photograph of it. He has a tremendous sense of humor. I think a lot of it turns up in his editing. There's a lot of humor in the context in which the portrait appears, in which he appears. The shadows are all self-portraits. I don't think there's some deep meaning in Lee photographing the television screen that didn't simply come out in the pictures. I think a lot of these pictures started when he was traveling. I could be wrong, but I think a lot of them are made in hotel rooms. There was a time in there where he would do a trip, and he worried that it was going to be a rainy day, and he'd go to the person he was making a contact with that was the reason for the trip, and he'd say, if it's rainy, I might like to be able to photograph somebody in the nude. Could you figure out who I could photograph? So the nudes developed as a mechanism for Lee to keep photographing even when the weather was lousy. The drive was to keep making pictures all the time. How could you resist letters on a wall? How can you resist vernacular letters, usually written by people who are not by definition literary? And how can you resist the poignant things that people say, that people feel they need to scrawl? If you try to talk to Lee about photography, he'll end up talking about a lens or a camera or something like that, or maybe film. The landscape pictures are all part and parcel of his evolving technology as a photographer. In the course of his photographic life, the focal length of his lenses have become shorter and shorter and shorter. So his landscapes have become a visual field that he's had to stand in to make the picture. So I think he's become tremendously interested in how the brush or bush that he's standing in turns itself into a picture when the angle of view is so much more extreme than the human eye has. Photography has become art with a capital A, and it's made the whole thing very odd because many very talented people are working, making pictures for galleries, and the galleries impose a set of standards on work that doesn't have much to do with what I think is interesting about the medium. So to me, Lee continues the great tradition of photography. I think he stands in awe of the pictures that are the best, and he has a pleasure out of making and seeing them, and he hopes others will have a pleasure out of seeing them as well. I don't think anybody can photograph and not be influenced by Lee. I mean, he's this massive force in the field. I think he's, without question, one of the most overwhelmingly influential photographers of our time.